Hey everyone, welcome back. In this video, I will be showing you how I made my Princess Jazmine blouse. This video is long overdue, but I hope that it can help you make your own Princess Jazmine cosplay. Here's a list of materials that you will be needing to get started. To start off, I did wrap myself in cling wrap and then added some duct tape to just one half of my body to draw out my pattern. Make sure you are wearing a blouse or something that is a little tighter to your body so that you can get a better fit. You will need a little bit of help towards the back, so in this case, I have my little brother drawing the back lines for me. They don't have to be perfect because we will be fixing this once we're done. Once you have the shape of your pattern, make sure to cut that out, but do not cut your shirt, so just be careful with that. So here we are just going to cut off the excess cling wrap and duct tape that you can see on the top and bottom of your pattern, just so that we can have something a lot cleaner. Okay, so here I am dividing my pattern into three sections to get the curvature of the bust and to make it easier to sew. Don't forget to add in your registration marks just so that you know how to line up your pieces together. And this is a process that you can do while you still have the pattern on, which would make it so much easier, but in my case I forgot, so here I am doing it afterwards. And then you can go ahead and cut out your pieces. Next, I just took some plain pieces of white paper, but you can use any craft paper or anything bigger if that's easier for you. And then just go ahead and trace your pattern on it. On the first pattern piece, I did mark that this is where there will be a fold in the fabric because it will be our center line. So then I took my teal fabric and folded a section of it, since we do have fold written on our pattern piece. That is exactly where you will place your pattern. Next, I took some chalk and traced my pattern. I did trace it right on the edge, but I will be adding a seam allowance afterwards. So for pattern sections 2 and 3, you don't need to have a fold in the fabric, but you do need two pieces of each section. Next, take your lining fabric and repeat these steps once more. Now you can start lining your fabric pieces together and pin them in place right at the registration marks. Once you have them pinned together, you can go ahead and sew straight down that side. So then you can repeat these steps with all of the remaining pieces until you have one big section sewed together. Once you have your pieces sewn together, you can go ahead and cut off that excess fabric. Then repeat the steps for your teal fabric. Once you're done, you should have two pieces that look like this. So then you place both pieces facing right sides together and you will pin them in place. Once you have them in place, you can go ahead and sew both top and bottom, but leave the sides open. You can then open one of the sides and flip it inside out. To close the sides, go ahead and fold it inwards about twice and then do a straight stitch. Next, I took some ribbon and made some loops on both sides. Once you're done making these loops, you can go ahead and take a long piece of ribbon and then just thread it through so that you can tie your blouse when you put it on. So about midway into editing this video, I realized that I did not record the process for the sleeves. But all I did for that was basically cut out two rectangles in the thickness that I saw fit for the sleeves, sewed them together, just like we did the shirt, leaving the sides open, flipped it inside out, and then attached it to where I saw fit. And that is how you make your Princess Jazmine blouse. If you would like to see part 2 on how I made the pants, make sure to like this video, subscribe, drop a comment down below, and turn on that little bell notification to get notified every time I post a new video. Thank you guys!